Hey guys, it's Pat. Welcome back to my channel. Today's video is the continuation of last week's video because in that video, I shared some Chrome extensions that I feel like are very, very useful for students like me. Now, some of the Chrome extensions there aren't very known to a lot of people, so if you haven't watched that yet, make sure to do so by clicking the card up here because I tell you, those Chrome extensions can help you study more efficiently. So anyway, in today's video, I wanted to share some apps and websites that can help you organize all of the workload that you have piling up, find resources that you need for writing, and create materials for studying. I have a lot of apps and websites, well, mostly websites that I want to share with you guys, and I swear all of these are very, very helpful. They've made a huge difference in the way that I make my presentations, in the way that I write my papers, and also in the way that I rewrite my notes. So if you want to know the must-have apps and websites that you need for school, then please keep on watching. I'm gonna start with the websites because I have a lot of them on my list, so I'm just gonna get them out of the way first. The first website on my list is SlidesGo. This is a website where you can find tons and tons of creative templates for your Google Slides or PowerPoint presentations. The templates are already arranged by category, so it's very convenient to navigate through them in case you're looking for a specific style that you want. So if you want to search for a template with a specific color, a specific style, or within certain categories, you can definitely do so. As you can see, they have templates for education, business, marketing, medical, multi-purpose, and even for infographics. I think this is very helpful because certain topics that you want to make a presentation on require certain styles. So for instance, if you want to make a minimalist presentation, you can easily go to that category and look for a template that would fit your style. Instead of having an additional waste of time trying to go through different presentations of different styles. So if you found the perfect template, for example, this back to school template, you just click on it and you can choose whether you want to use it as a Google Slides theme or as a PowerPoint presentation. If you choose to download it as a Google Slides theme, it automatically redirects you to that website. And if you choose to download it as a PowerPoint presentation, you don't have to worry about losing the font style or having the graphics misplaced because I know that that tends to happen a lot of times. So whether you have the font downloaded in your computers or not, the template will stay that way because everything's already embedded. The next website that I have for you is Canva, which also provides various creative templates for your next design. Unlike SlidesGo, which is only limited to presentations and infographics, Canva provides a lot of templates for different materials. They have templates for Facebook, Instagram posts, posters, logos, infographics, as in everything that you're looking for is here. Every element, graphics, templates are also easily accessible in Canva, so you can mix and match different templates if that's what you want, because you will find this struggle within yourself when you're on Canva that you have too many options to the point that you can't decide which one to choose. So if you want the color scheme from this certain template but you still want to retain the elements in the template that you originally chose, you can easily combine those together without having to download each and every file. Also, with SlidesGo kasi, you'll notice that most of the graphics there, well, not all naman ha, but most of them are merged together, so it's harder to edit. But with Canva, the graphics can be ungrouped, so if you just want to change a tiny detail, you can easily do so. Next is Hemingway. Now, in my last video, I've talked about Grammarly, which I'm sure you're already very familiar with. So Hemingway basically is another alternative to Grammarly that checks the readability of your writing. In Hemingway, every error that it sees in your writing is highlighted in different colors, each color corresponding to a different error. So blue tells you of any word that you can remove from your passage, so this can be adverbs that aren't really necessary to your text. Green tells you of any sentence that is in passive voice, so usually you just have to alter your sentence into an active voice. Purple notifies you of any word that has a simpler alternative, in this case, use for utilize. Yellow highlights any sentence in your passage that is hard to read, so usually Hemingway tells you to shorten that sentence or to split it into two sentences. Last is red, which highlights any sentence in your passage that is very hard to read and very complex to understand. Usually, these sentences are highlighted in red because Hemingway suggests that your reader will get lost in this part of your text. The next website on my list is Quizlet. I don't think I need to say much about this because I'm sure a lot of students are very familiar with this already. So basically, Quizlet is an online learning tool where you can make flashcards to practice and master what you're learning. You can use it on your laptop, on your phones, or on your tablets, and how it works is you create sets for certain topics that you want to review. So you can add the term, it's definitely definition, and you can also add an image if you want to. So instead of writing them down on pieces of paper, which I know can be very tedious and tiring, you can simply type your notes here and you're good to go. Next is Slater, which is a website where you can find answers to your textbook problems. I wish I'd known this website earlier than I did, because it has been my frustration when textbook provides you all these practice problems, but they don't give you at least the answer to them. Though I cannot guarantee that all of the answers in your textbooks are going to be here, but at least you have somewhat of a help and a website that you can go to in case you're looking for answers to your textbook problems. So when you go to Slater, you just have to type in the title of your textbook. It already shows you a bunch of results that are similar and somewhat along the lines of the textbook that you searched. So you just have to go through the different results. After finding your book, it tells you how many expert verified solutions there are, and it already lists out the answers per chapter. So you just have to go through which chapter and what page the problem is in. So I think this is very, very helpful when you're studying, because you get to know whether your answer is correct or not in a very convenient way. The last website that I have for you is BioRender, which is a website where you can make science illustrations and figures in case you need that extra help when studying or when rewriting your notes. I think this is useful when studying because for me, since I am a visual learner, I like to draw and make illustrations of processes to help me understand them better. So with BioRender, you can make different illustrations to help you understand certain concepts. Also, this is very helpful when rewriting your notes because in my case, I like to attach, again, figures on my notes to help me understand them better. So just in case I can't find the perfect illustration on Google, I can just make it here. Aside from creating your illustrations, you can also choose from a bunch of templates that they have. So these templates range from general figures, genetics, anatomy, ecology, any topic that you can think of under science, you can do it here. So after you choose the template that you want to use, you can easily customize certain icons from a bunch of icons that they offer. As you can see, every element that you can think of in any scientific process is here. You just have to be very meticulous when it comes to finding the perfect icons. You can also edit the text, position, so basically you can customize the templates to your preferred content and format. Moving on to the apps that I have for you, the first one on my list is Google Suite, which I'm sure most of you are very familiar with already. The ones that I often use are Google Docs and Google Drive. There are also Slides, Sheets, Keeps, and a bunch of other productivity tools, so you just have to check which suits your needs best. Since Google Suite is online, I mostly use this for group work because it allows you to create, edit, and view documents as a group. So if you're working on a paper or a presentation, you can do it at the same time your groupmate does, so you can talk about it through while going through the entire process. In this way, kasi, you can avoid going through another phase in your group work just to revise certain errors or to ask questions about certain parts. Next is Microsoft Office. Now, the only ones that I often use are Microsoft Word for my reviewers and PowerPoint for creative materials. I have stuck with Microsoft Word for note-taking because it's already very convenient to print my notes there, and every tool is very straightforward. So, I mean, if it's not broken, why fix it? Now, for PowerPoint, a lot of people underestimate this app, but you can actually do so many creative things with this. I'm using it not just for my presentations, but also for posters, infographics, even some animations in my videos, and basically any creative material that I need. What I usually do is I look for an inspiration in Pinterest and Canva, and that becomes my basis for creating the material in my own preference and style. I'm also gonna share a tool in the browser version of PowerPoint that I feel like is very, very useful for a lot of students. So if you go to the browser version of PowerPoint, you open up your presentation and then you go to slideshow, you can see an option which says rehearse with coach. So this is essentially a rehearsal function that gives feedback at the end of your rehearsal. You can see how much time you spent, whether your pacing is just right, how good your pitch variation is. It also tells you whether you've avoided reading the slide text and if ever there are sensitive phrases found. I believe this is a very helpful tool to practice your speaking skills before your presentation day so you can check which areas you need to work on. Next is Trello. Trello is a visual project management app that allows you to organize all your projects and collaborate with the different members of your group. So basically, Trello uses boards to organize different cards, each card representing whatever project or task you're working on. As you can see on this pre-made template, there is a board for to-do lists, pending tasks, and accomplished goals, so you can fully customize the template to whatever your needs are. Each card opens up to a new page, which is great because it wouldn't feel overwhelming when you see it at first sight. You can also share this with your groupmates or collaborators so that they know what part of the project you're already in or what steps you're still lacking. The last app that I have for you, and by far the most powerful app on this list, is Notion. Notion is an all-in-one workspace that enables you to create, plan, and get organized. I don't think I'll be able to give justice to this app in this video because you can do so many things with this, and I'm still customizing it to the way that I want to use it. Right now, I just use this for my content calendar, but I'm planning to integrate my academic deadlines here so I won't have to go through different apps just to look for a certain deadline. So Notion already provides a bunch of templates that are very helpful for all the aspects in your life. If you want your self-improvement mindfulness area here, you can have journal entries and even a habit tracker. If you're a content creator, you can also have a content calendar. If you're a student, you can also have all your courses organized and your notes stored here. Every database, every task, every aspect in your life that you need to plan and organize, you can do it here. And what's great is you have all these things in just one app, so you don't need to go to different apps for different tasks. You can only have Notion and you have all of your different tasks organized. So those are all of the apps and websites that I have for you. I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, please don't hesitate to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. Thank you so much, and I will see you in my next videos.